All right, so my name is Yakub Ossoff. I've been part of CRC for about the last 6 years, and I've been a faithful tither for the last 6 years. So the biggest turning point actually came about 5 years ago when I read Pastor Aidan's book, Unless a Seed, which is all about the importance of putting seed in the ground, letting that seed die so that it can produce a harvest, and also the importance of the seed, the fruit of a seed is inside the seed itself. So in the book, I also learned the importance of whatever man sows, you shall reap. So you sow money, you'll reap money. You sow kindness, you'll reap kindness. You sow honor, you'll reap honor. So obviously for me, it was just a basic principle of sowing into money. So I never started tithing just because I wanted more money. I started because it was a principle. And being part of CRC gave me a clear vision. And when I started working, I had a clear vision of what I wanted to earn to see my breakthrough. So I had a clear vision. I wanted to earn an X amount at the end of the year. And I worked it out backwards. So every month I needed to tithe a little bit more and add a little bit more so that I can reach my final goal. So I decided I'm going to tithe towards my salary I wanted to earn and not that I was what I was currently earning. So each month I would tithe and I would sow into good ground, and then I would see breakthrough, and I would keep on sowing and I would see breakthrough. But it came towards the end of the year where I got my final increase. So it was short of the vision that I had. So I had a choice. I can now go back to God and say, well, I'm going to tithe less now because I didn't get the amount that I wanted. Or I can still be faithful and sow that last seed into the ground, which is more than what I wanted to sow because I didn't reach my end vision or my end goal, you can say. But I decided I'm still going to be faithful. As I said, I never started this tithing out of receiving more money. It was a principle. And then I sowed that seed into the ground, and the breakthrough then only came about 5 months after that. When I laid that final seed into the ground, my boss came to me and said after the audit, I was only one of two people that received the 14th check in that year. And then after that, it just snowballed. So every year I would receive a 30% to a 20% increase. I think the most amazing part about tithing into ground is also nice to see your money kind of in action, because you can put it into a bank, but you can't really see your money. It's just there. You just see numbers. But tithing into good ground, you can see people's life being impacted every Sunday. You can see people's life literally change in front of your eyes. And to know that your tithing had a part of that is something that you can never take away from anybody. It's nice to see, and that's also the biggest incentive why I would never ever stop tithing, to see people's life on a Sunday change, Sunday after Sunday, to see people at harvest events, life literally change, and people surrender their lives, and just the smile on their faces makes it all worthwhile, to see the balcony in the church go up, and to see the youth growing and expanding because of the balcony that was there, and know that you had an input into that and a tithing into that. I think that is something that will always keep me motivated and to keep me on tithing. So I always look for new opportunities for good ground to sow into. For example, the harvest events that we do every year, the CRC Kids Church that do the back to school bags every year. And I think currently with the stage that we're going to expand and the mother's room, I think it's a perfect opportunity to sow into good ground and to see your money in action and to see people's life changed. Because this is going to be something that's going to last forever. People's lives are going to be changed forever with the money that you're going to sow into good ground. So good ground will always be the church, members of the church, home cell members, people that's committed to the church. It's always good ground to sow into. I started tithing for my first paycheck because the Bible is clear when it comes to tithing, and the word of God is final in your life. Whatever God's word says, that is final. So I never questioned it. I never went against it. It was just very clear for me. The Holy Spirit was very clear when I decided I'm going to start tithing. I never skipped a month. And I will always try to be generous in every area that I can. I think that's important when it comes to the Bible. You can't expect blessings in your life if you're not faithful to what God has given you. Because God is a God of principle. He's testing your heart. He's not after you. The money is after your heart. So if He has your heart, He will give you anything. But it all starts about being faithful and sowing and just realizing, listen, this is not about money. It's about seeing people saved on a Sunday. It's seeing people's life change because you are sowing to something that's greater and bigger than yourself. So the word of God is also very clear when it comes to tithing. In Malachi 3:10, God says, test me on this, that if you bring your tithe to the storehouse, you will open up the windows of heaven and you will pour out such a blessing that there won't even be enough room in your storehouse to contain His blessings. The Bible also says in Proverbs 3, verse 9 to 10, that if you bring your first fruits and you increase to the house of God, He will supply your every need, so you will never live in lack. The Bible also says in Isaiah 32 verse 8 that generous people plan to be generous and they stand firm in their generosity. So it's a choice that you're going to have to make to be generous. And it's not always going to have to be a feeling, but it's a choice to still be generous even though you might not feel like it. Yeah, so the Bible is very clear when it comes to where your treasure is, there your heart will be. So I think tithing is a very important sign to show that you are planted and part of a church. You are committed to building God's kingdom, and you are sold out to do anything to see his kingdom grow. So don't see it as money. See it as something that you're building a legacy that's going to still be there when you leave one day. And every time you see somebody saved on a Sunday, you know that that is part of your fruit, because your money helped in order to keep the lights on and to keep the building going so that you can see people saved. And that's our main focus here. Because to see people's lives change, I think that's the biggest gift that your money can ever give. Even if you don't receive anything back, just to know that people's lives are forever changed should be enough to tithe. I'm responsible, I'm committed, and I've decided to be a faithful tither in the house of CRC. I want to encourage everybody to be a faithful tither in the house of CRC and to sow into good ground so that we can win the lost at any cost, and you will see what God will do in your life.